the zero line which goes through London that was set up by this guy. This whole system of time zones is based on the Gregorian calendar. That's why they want us all busy looking at the zero point. They don't want you to think about what the calendar is really about, what the alignment is really about. They want you to focus on people running around the track. And when the doomsday point doesn't happen, the doomsday point doesn't happen, people go, well, Mayans were stupid, weren't they? Nothing happened. They weren't that great, were they?
Is it build it up?
I don't have any Olympic highlights on. I've got digital now. So pretty insidious plan, I think.
The Olympics will be in the summer. Doomsday point is in December.
Yeah. So, well, the whole year is going. Is filled with all kinds of things. Queen Elizabeth's 60th anniversary is in 2012 as well.
It's subtle energy, really.
There's going to be that's going to be everywhere. Queen Elizabeth, 60 years of power. The Olympics, digital, yay! Meanwhile, this pointer in the sky, this beautiful 26,000 year cycle, comes to an end and nobody's watching it. Or if they are, they're going, it's doomsday. When nothing happens, yeah, the Olympics were good though, weren't they? And what about the Queen?
You think we'd have learned after the Millennium and the Millennium Bubble?
But what would our
absolutely.
But if it is, we get to that 2012 point, what would our next consciousness be? What would you be?
Conscious co-creation.
We'll find out.
Conscious co-creation.
Can't wait.
I just want to go back a little bit. I want to go back a little bit to explain this. I'll have to tap through quickly. Just briefly. Okay, that'll do. So, as I was saying, that day five is when the new sort of consciousness comes online, if you like. Day five, back in the day, was the Bible. For the first time, people were able to correlate this idea of, you know, one God or the Saviour. Jesus Christ, whatever you think about him, his message is, Caesar is not God, no man is God, but we are all divine. Okay? That's kind of the thing, that his message. And in the next one, well, I couldn't really find one here. I was trying to think, well, where is this one? I'm not sure. But in day five of this galactic underworld, ethics, I was trying to think what happened here. And for me, the new ethics is oriented to what was known as the truth movement. The truth movement exploded here. This is when it all happened, around this time. Not just the Merseyside truth movement, any of that. Globally, everyone was really starting to say, hold on a minute, power, we've seen what you do. And what did they do? They went around handing out DVDs for free. Video after video went online of people handing out videos that they made themselves for free. How more ethical can you get than that? And we're talking the new consciousness here. I think that's the kind of new consciousness, the conscious co-creation, where if you're a power mad person trying to keep hold of your power, the only way to do that is to kill people. I'm sorry, but that's not viable anymore. And we know that. Everybody knows that now.
What was it?
Globally.
Ian talked about intention as well. So taking that intention of what you believe in and ensuring it's positive means that your intention will blossom.
Yeah, intention. Intention creates reality. So how many people here have heard of or talked to somebody who's going to Iraq or Afghanistan and says they don't want to go?
Most want to go. Most
that's
care.
This. That's this. They don't want to go anymore. They can't quite figure out how not to yet, but it's getting better. I think this system, if anything, you know, relating to 2012, this is more viable than any of them. It's certainly better than Doomsday. So what we're talking about at the end of the day is global time, cyclic time versus linear time. And if you're going to focus on 2012, remember that it's time cyclic, and what you reap you will sow. Okay, thanks a lot. I'd just like to thank Lee for turning up again.
Sorry.
Really gives us a good and interesting talk. And for the next 15-20 minutes, it's open to the floor. Anyone who wants to leave questions, then please ask, and I'm sure you'll do your best to answer.
I will try my damnedest.
I don't know whether you believe him, Mike, but you know, go for it. Any questions you've got, please feel free.
Anybody?
Oh.
No?
No?
Oh, yeah.
I don't think language raises our consciousness. I think it's
not the whole of consciousness.
It's an energy download that raises our consciousness.
You're talking about energy downloads here. They weren't downloading stuff.
Sorry.
If you're pulling me up on language, downloading, as we know it, you're talking matrix speak there.
Yeah, but language
is
created.
We're talking 3115 BC.
Yeah, but language is created, so we lose our telepathy.
But that's a theory. That's a theory, and it may well be, and you may well have been the genius that has figured it all out.
Well, I'm not a genius.
But as far as I'm concerned, language helps consciousness evolve.
Yeah, but where did language
that's
come
what I
from?
Said.
Ancient Babylon. Where did all this come from? Ancient Babylon. Where did the Roman Catholic Church come from? Babylon.
Well, yeah, but I mean,
that's all control mechanism.
I wouldn't mind, mate.
Yeah, that's where it all started.
Yeah, just hit what you're having. That'd be cool. Thank you.
Well, Stephen.
In
my opinion, if language was great, it'd bring us down, not raise us up.
Without language, you wouldn't have just been able to express that point.
Sorry.
Without language, you wouldn't have just expressed that point.
You don't know that.
Animals
communicate in telepathy.
I do in this time and place based on this civilization's calendar, which is the focus of consciousness for this civilization, which is based on language and numbers.
If there's going to be a consciousness shift, do you believe that there's going to be a broader range of colour spectrum? If we go through like a fourth dimension, if we could say, for instance, go into the fourth dimension, and plus, would it change time so we live longer? For instance, we could live up to 1,000 years if time changes.
These things are completely feasible.
Yeah.
As far as imagination goes, but that's why I stayed away from imagining what might happen, and I looked at what people are saying will happen.
But we need imagination
based on certain
consciousness.
Astronomical things.
But we need imagination for the shift to move on. Without imagination,
yeah, you do need imagination.
Lockdown, and that's what we're trying to stop imagination.
You can imagine anything into being.
Yeah.
Absolutely anything.
If you don't have imagination, and you just believe in the solid world, which most people do, and if you don't think anything else is possible, then it's game over, they've won.
You don't believe nothing else is possible, and I certainly don't. I don't know about anyone else in this room.